someone that I used to go to when Al Masjid needed anything. He was my liaison between Al Haq and the Gambian community. He used to rally them, he used to gather them, anything that was happening in this masjid. The first Jumu'ah, the first Friday of this month of Ramadan, we were supposed to have an international iftar with the Gambian community, the Senegalese community, and the Mauritanian community. Sherif Diallo made sure every single Gambian in this city knew about it. And he gathered so much food and drinks, and he brought it here in the masjid. His wife cooked and brought it here in the masjid. That is how important he was to our community. That is such a pillar that he was in our community. So we have lost a big one. We have lost a big one. This is an example, brothers. But this is how we should be in our communities. Be in the need of your brother. Support your brother and your sister. And Allah will be for you when you are in need of Him. And let us make islah bayna nas. Let us make reconciliation. Let us put love and rahmah and forgiveness between us. Because the day will come just like today. And we have no idea. We do not know who is going to wash our body. We do not know who is going to bury us. A few brothers today we went. Sharif was a strong man, was a tall and big man. Like any person who dies, when you lay on the table, you cannot move by yourself. You cannot do anything by yourself. Everything you need your own brothers to do it for you. Every single day, especially on Jumu'ah, when you make that ghusl, getting ready for Jumu'ah, coming to the masjid, remember a day will come that some people will make that ghusl for you. You cannot do it for yourself. Even to lift an arm, you cannot. Even if the flies are coming in your mouth, we have to wipe them off. We have to wipe front and back. We have to cleanse you. You raise one arm, it goes down. Mankind does not realize that there was a time, هَلْ أَتَى عَلَى الْإِنسَانِ حِينٌ مِنَ الدَّهْرِ لَمْ يَكُنْ شَيْءٌ مَذْكُورًا. Do you realize, my brother? Do you realize, my sister, that there was a time that you were not even worth mentioning? A time in your life, you were nothing but a drop of sperm. Not even worth mentioning. But today, you become old. You become rich. Then you become strong. And you become arrogant. You become boastful. And some will raise their hands. Or they will hit their chest and say, I don't care about people. I don't care about anybody. I don't need people. I'm self-sufficient. I can do it all by myself. But remember when you are laid on the table. Remember when we have to press your stomach. And even feces will come out. And we have to wash you. Remember that day we have to wrap you. Remember that day we put you in the grave. In that hole that is deep and hard. And that is dark. And no one will be there with you. The grave is reality. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he said in a hadith that is reported by Anas ibn Malik, that when the person is placed in his grave, two angels will come as soon as the people walk away. And indeed, the dead person will hear the footsteps of the people who bury him. He will even hear the voices as they talk and walk away from him. And they dumped him in that hole. Regardless how much they loved you, whether it is your wife, your husband, your children, your cousins, your brothers and sisters, your imams, nobody will love you enough to say, I will stay with him in the grave. Everyone will be eager to get rid of you and go back to their daily affairs. On that moment, on that scary time, on that time of loneliness, on that time which you will depend on no one but yourself, and your actions. Two angels will come and they will sit you up. Munkar wa Nakir. Listen to their names. Munkar wa Nakir. They will come and they will sit you up. And they will ask you, we know the three questions. But in this hadith by Anas ibn Malik, the Prophet ﷺ only focused on the last question. And then they will ask you, what do you say about this man Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? If you were a believer, you will say, I bear witness that he is a slave and a messenger of Allah. May Allah help us be among those who will testify that. And then the angels will show you a place in the hellfire. And they will tell you, this was supposed to be your house in the hellfire. But because of your good deeds, we have replaced it for you with a beautiful palace in paradise. May Allah give it to us. But as for the person who is a non-believer, who do not follow the tenets of the Quran and the Hadith, the person who is a hypocrite, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, when he's asked about this man, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he will say, I do not know. I do not know. I only said about him what I heard other people say about him. And they will tell him, neither did you have the knowledge, nor did you seek the guidance from those who know. Give a good testimony of us. His co-workers, his wife's co-workers, everyone who knew Sharif said something good about him. And let me inform you that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said,
just ahead, move it closer, closer, yes, closer. Remove this black thing.